Opaka says he was an instructor by then as sergeant and came with his recruits to control the crowd that day. He says he had some of the white people as his friends and saw how many of them were not happy at Kololo.
I was a sergeant, and on Independence Day, on that day, I took the recruits to do the work of crowd control at Kololo. Now it is called Kololo Airstrip, Kololo. So, on that day, it was at night actually, around midday.
Midnight.
The flag.
Midnight.
The British flag was lowered. And then they raised the Uganda flag up. Then what I saw, some of the Wazungus, I call them Wazungus, whipped, seeing the British flag lowered. And people were very happy. On that day, people were very, very happy getting independence.
Meanwhile, while comparing Uganda of then and now, Opaka says there are many things that have been done by Ugandans and were not done by the colonialists. Opaka, who is now 87 years old, says the major roads in Uganda were established by Ugandans after independence, and this has continued to date.
As far as I know, Uganda is better now. And then, Kitanando, Otodoko Yot, because of better roads. Kampala is very large, with Kedegedo Tech Health Center. Almost every sub-county has a health center.
However, Opaka says he is not pleased with how guns are handled currently. Report by Michael Onyinge for the news.